Happy day, children. Do good and good will come to you. Always do good to others so that you will receive good in return. Okay, let us go into the topic. Already we have seen about phrase and class. I hope you know the definition. Let us go for some examples, then we can see here. Lala, Lola sang beautifully. Here you see it has a subject and verb, so it is class. An abandoned ship. You see here it is a group of words, but no verb subject, so it is phrase. The white flower, same way it is phrase, it's a set of words, no subject, no verb. The boy kicked the football, it has a subject and verb, so it is a clause. Opposite the park, it is a phrase. The wind howled fiercely, so class. So from that it is clear that class is a set of words with subject and verb, phrase is a set of words without subject and verb. It won't give you the complete meaning. Class, it gives you the complete meaning. Let us see what is how phrase versus class. Phrase, clause. A clause is a part of the sentence that contains a verb. A typical clause consists of a subject and predicate, the latter typically a verb phrase, a verb with any objects and other modifiers. For example, he must stop laughing. They have done the job. Tom likes the meat. We like the music that you brought. Then phrase. Phrase is a small group of words that adds meaning to a sentence. A phrase is not a sentence, but because it is not a complete idea with a subject, verb and predicate. Example. The information age. Noun phrase. Earnest in a desire. Adjective phrase. Much too quickly to see clearly. Adverb phrase. After a very long walk. It is a prepositional phrase. We don't want to go into deep. Just you learn what is a clause, what is a phrase. So already we have seen about main clause, dependent clause. Let us see conditionals. That is if clause. That is it has already classes, we know it. In that if clause. So type 0 is present simple plus present simple. That is if you eat the ice, it melts. So present simple present. You have to use present tense in both the tense. If clause type 1. That is, if you eat too much, you will gain weight. You see here, if you eat too much, here the verb eat is simple present. The verb is used in its base form. You will gain weight. That is, will plus present form of the verb. So, will gain weight, that is future tense. Then type 2, past simple plus would plus v1. If I had time, I would visit my parents. If I had time, I would visit my parents. You see the condition itself, it is a imaginary one. Then if class type 3, past perfect tense plus would have, don't go for tenses. If I earned a lot of money, I would have bought a house. Just don't go for the tenses and all. Just you can go with the word. If plus present simple, to talk about things that are always true, like a scientific fact. If you freeze water, it turns into ice. That is already, you know, simple present tense used to for universal truths. Standard sayings. And if you eat water at 100 degrees, it boils. If students miss an exam, the professor fails them. If my wife has a cold, I usually catch it. I get tired if I work too much. If I am late for dinner, they start eating without me. You see that all the highlighted verbs are in the base form. That is present, simple present. Present form of the verb is used. You have to, we can say it as V1. So it is zero type, it is not given in your book anyway. You just learn it. All the true things, scientific facts comes under the zero type. Most probably your usage of your simple present tense. You will be learning tenses. First conditional, that is if plus, the structure is if plus simple present plus simple future. That is will or won't plus V base form. To talk about possibilities in the present or in the future. It talks about if you work hard, you will get first rank. If it rains, I will stay at home. If I wake up late, I will miss the bus. And if it is sunny, we will go to the park. See all possible things. If Joanne leaves, Paula will be sad. If I find your email, I will send you the picture. If you study hard, you will pass your exams. So the usage structure is simple present, that is the verb is in its base form, and simple future, it should be in this format, will plus present form of the verb. Then the next one, second conditional, the structure is if plus, you have to use the verb where, that is a past simple, and the would or wouldn't plus base form, that is fully imaginary. If I were a bird, I would fly. If I won $1,000,000, I would, you see, if I won, that itself an imaginary one, I would buy a new car. If I were you, I would quit smoking. Nobody can be others. So it is an imaginary condition. If I were you, I would quit smoking. If I were the president, I would lower taxes. They would stay longer if they had more time. If I won $1,000,000, I could stop working. If I had more free time, I could travel around the world. All these cells are the imaginary condition. That is, first one is open condition. Second one is imaginary condition. That is second conditional, type 2. It is imaginary condition. The format is past tense, here would plus V1. You learn the format, that is enough. Then if plus past perfect, that is add plus past participle form of the verb, and then would plus have plus past participle. So I have given the list too, so it will be easy for you, and I have attached a PDF too. You can write at your back of your classwork, so it will be easy for you. You have to learn it, children, otherwise it is very difficult. Here it is imaginary situation. The situation is itself in the past, that is too imaginary. If I had got a gold medal, I would have been happy. If I had met Susan last week, I would have given her the book. If the weather had been good, you see the highlighted words, the format you have to learn, that's important. We would have gone water skiing. If you had got, you have to use got, and this American English. So up earlier, you would have caught the earlier train. So it is impossible that the condition will be fulfilled because it refers to the past, the condition. Now let us go for the verbs. Verbs means, you know, it shows the action. Action, what do you see? The girl jump. The baby sleeps. A man eats a burger. Whatever the action we do in our life, all comes under verbs. Why I have taken this topic means because you have base form there, past participle, so that only. You see different types of different action, riding, ride, write, cook, paint, dance, sleep, cook, whatever it may be, all comes under, all the action word comes under verb means at once you have to say that it is a action word. And one more thing, it can say the state of being. A verb is a word that expresses an action, a state of being, what the person does. You see here, the action is here, she ironed her dress. Here the verb is ironing, she is doing, she irons her clothes. Here you see, she feels tired, she is lying on a sofa. The state of being, what the person does, she feels tired. It is also, it is not an action word, but it tells the state of being. So it is also comes under verb. So action word or state of being. So I have given the list of verbs, that is forms of verb. I said no, V1, V2, V3. Here V1 is present form of the verb, past form of the verb. Here V3 is past participle. Die, died, died. Load, loaded, loaded. Thrust, thrust, thrust. You see, some of the three forms are same. Sent, sent, sent. And, hanged, hanged. Quit, quit, quit. Dance, dance, danced. Broadcast, broadcast, broadcast. Actually, broadcasted will come, but it is given like that. Lock, lock, lock. Beat, bet. Spelling is same. Beat. End, ended, ended. So, sowed, sowed. Begin, began, begun. Set, set, set. Begin, B-E-G-U-N. Begin. So, here it is broadcasted. It is given wrongly. And then here, began, begin. B-E-G-U-N. B-E-G-U-N. Then let us go for the next step. Be form verb. Was, where. Here it is been. Beat, bet, beaten. Become, became, become. Begin, began, began. It is given correctly. Come, came, come. Cost, cost, cost. Cut, cut, cut. Dig, dug, dug. Do, did, done. Draw, drew, drawn. Drive, drove, driven. Drink, drank, drunk. Eat, ate, eaten. Fall, fell, fallen. feel, felt, felt, fight, fought, fought, find, found, found, fly, flew, flown, forget, forgot, forgotten, forgive, forgave, forgiven. So children, these love verb form, if you learn only, it will be easy for you. This is some of the verbs I have discussed. I have given a PDF. You write in your classwork. At the last three pages, you can use it for your verb forms. No need to buy a grammar notebook. You can write in here. It is necessary. You must do it, children. Now, let us go for our word of the day. I hope you are following it. It will be very useful, children. So, please make use of it. Today, the word is bland. Bland. Land, we say, no, bland. Meaning, having very little taste, that is tasteless. If your mummy does a new things, you will be saying it is very nice, means you will be saying otherwise it is tasteless, you will be saying the same thing. Synonym, that is unflavored, unappetizing, insipid. Example, most people think British food is bland. So the word is bland, having very little taste, tasteless. Unflavored, unappetizing, insipid. Most people think British food is bland. So children, make use of this. I have given a PDF for writing your verbs. And the conditional class book exercise also I have given in PDF. Complete the exercises. Then send a video. I have seen the video in the group as well as your completed assignment images. Without fail. Thank you children. Have a